W-4 is very complex. It's five steps.
As many as five steps, along with three full pages of detailed instructions. Accountant Jeremy Saladino says the new form reflects new tax withholding changes that took effect in 2018 under the radar for many taxpayers.
With the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act last year, there were a lot of people that got surprises at the end of the year because the payroll taxes changed and the withholdings were not withheld enough.
The IRS says the newly designed W-4 is meant to be more transparent and less complex, but some of you might still have to declare your qualifying dependents, even though you can no longer take exemptions for dependents.
You have three children. Your children are 22, graduating the UW, 17, last year in high school, and 13.
Before the change, you'd get an exemption of $3,000 per child. That's $9,000 of income that wouldn't get taxed. Now, you'll get a $500 tax credit for each of the two older kids and $2,000 in tax credits for the youngest child. That's a total of $3,000 in tax credits that can ultimately affect your withholding.
For some, that's a better deal. For others, that's not.
The new W-4 also has an important section for people with multiple jobs or couples who both work, where both taxpayers might need to check a special box. I found a video on the IRS website that explains the W-4 process, including a tax withholding estimator that can help you figure out what your withholding should be.
I'm told there's even confusion among some professional tax preparers and employers about what you should do if you have multiple jobs in this case, or two people who work. So don't let this fall through the cracks. I'll put a link to frequently asked W-4 questions in this story in the consumer section of KOMONews.com. And to answer Mary's question, if you haven't looked at it in a while, look at your current W-4, mm-hmm. and if it's not correct, okay. update it.